And the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. St. John 10, verse 10. Are there any questions?
Hey, watch it, baby. This cat is heavy on religion.
I can see this has become a struggle between good and evil. Satan has a question.
Yes, sir, Chaplain Gill, but since neither one of us are God, I don't think either one of us are in any position to say who's good and who's evil.
Why don't you just ask your question?
We were discussing the disciples. What color were they?
Well, I don't think we know that for certain.
But they were Hebrews, were they not?
That's right.
As was Jesus. Jesus was also a Hebrew.
Why don't you just ask your question?
What color were the original Hebrews?
I have told you that we don't know that for certain.
Then you can't believe for certain that Jesus was white.
Just a moment. God is white. Isn't it obvious?
Well, that is obvious, but we don't know if it's obvious that God is white. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that Jesus did not have blonde hair and blue eyes. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that the images of Jesus that are on prison walls and churches throughout the world are not historically correct, because history teaches us that Jesus was born in a region where the people had color. There's proof in the very Bible that you ask us to read in Revelation 1st chapter, verse 14 and 15, that Jesus had hair like wool and feet the color of brass.
Just what are you saying?
I'm not saying anything. I'm proving to you that Jesus was not, and I might quote one of our Indian brothers, he was not a pale face. Aha. Amen.
Isn't that interesting?